Okay. And many people, they fall from that. What will happen is that at some point of time, that power starts leaving them. So then you start to have to put start bogus. Okay, you should start using magic tricks to substitute. So these are mental powers. Mind is not a stable entity at all. So it starts dropping. Okay. Whereas there are some people, the spiritual power they acquire, but they don't show it. They will use it only for a purpose of some spiritual work. Something has to be uplifted in the society. For that purpose, they will use it.
But they will use it.
Yeah, you will use it. For some specific reasons. For example, Swami Vivekananda had so many siddhis. Okay? He used it appropriately whenever it's required. He didn't use it for name and fame. Like that also is there. So, we can't say exactly this is how behavior happens, but the moment you get trapped in the name and fame, so the simple spirituality, you may get the feeling that I am enlightened also. Okay, that may be ego trap. Okay? You don't know which ego is so subtle, you may one day proclaim that I am enlightened, I have done. Okay?
How will he know that?
That's what I'm saying. Don't worry about knowing. I'm saying...
No. How will he know that he is in the trap?
No. Somebody I don't say... I'm saying I'm giving a safeguard mechanism for that. What I'm saying, focus your life on Atmanam Mokshartam Jagaditaya. Service. Okay? Keep a service attitude. And keep saying, I am self-realization. Don't say, this is the point I am self-realized, this is not the point I am self-realized. This activity keeps us continuous activity. Self-realization and service. Don't make it a milestone. Okay? If you are doing service, okay, if your ego is still left, you start getting bloated. The service is the safest safety net for a self-realization. Because it's a test for you. You understand? See, there's no other test. Atmano Mokshartam Jagaditaya is kept as actually a safeguard. Jagaditaya means when I do service and I interact with society. Right? The society interaction will bring the backlash. Whatever way, you are doing the best thing in the world, people will start criticizing you. Then you'll know, how am I, peaceful or not. So every day you have to expose the ego to lashes and dissolve. So how long you don't worry, that pull and push will dissolve it. Everybody, the Atman Mokshatam Jagadita is not just told just like that. The moment you try to service in the society, there will be criticism, there is negativity, all those things will come. Then your ego starts getting fried. If you say you are really enlightened and ego starts getting fried, there is nothing to get fried. Then you know. And you are a self-realized person, continue to do service. Until his vasana so dry out, he becomes simply sitting. So best safeguard for you is Atmanu Mokshatam, Shravana Manana Nidhyasa, keep continuing. Jagadithyaya, keep doing some service, whatever service you can do. And in service, when you do service, some lot of criticism will come, negativity will come, everything will come. That's like poison, let it come. That will strengthen your realization.
Guruji, Atma is for?
Atmano Mokshartha means, I will do everyday work for my self-realization. What is the work? Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. Jagaditaya. I will keep doing some service. Without expecting anything, I will keep doing service. Jagaditaya.
So, everyday I work. Atmano Mokshartam
Jagaditaya. So, don't wait for a day I am getting enlightened. Okay? So, it will be a non-event. You won't know when it has happened, just it will be a non-event. It will not be a big, massive, earth-shaking event. So, I am telling you, there is a push and pull will happen here. Okay? The push and pull will... One day the ego will go puss, won't you know? Are you clear? Otherwise, when will I happen, enlightenment happen? You study that, there will be a book on enlightenment, life enlightenment stories. So this guy got enlightenment, this guy got enlightenment, this guy got enlightenment. You start developing expectations. That's a block. So you say, you have to ask a question, am I in the right enlightenment process or not? If you are on the right track, you will reach the destination sometime. Don't worry about that because you don't know which point. But this has a activity. Atmanu Mokshatam Jagaditaya. For self-realization, I'll do Sravana, Manan, Vidyasa. Jagaditaya, I'll do service. So, when your self is realized, the desire for Sravana, Manana will come down, naturally. Jagaditaya, when your desire for serving the world, the Vasana will come down. This will all happen very naturally, you don't have to force. The moment you force, the ego is coming to you. Any questions? So, don't look for a such person, enlightened persons, outer science. There's nobody. But, there are certain characteristics. Enlightened persons, in the enlightened persons, if he starts taking teachers, he becomes a guru or teacher, then people start feeling peace in his presence. Okay, there's a deeper peace felt. Then another thing which happens is all the questions will go down. All nonsense questions will stop coming. So questions will disappear and peace will happen and you start getting realization is simple. So that is the sign of an enlightened person. Otherwise, there's no external signs for an enlightened person. Is it clear? Now who asked the question, you feel peaceful here? So, her question is, I feel peaceful here, more peaceful when I sit and meditate here. So, because one is that I am sitting here and my presence is there. Okay, my mind is much more silent and that presence will affect you. Second thing is, this place where we are sitting, Atmadana is happening every day. The stones and walls of this place also will have that
vibration.
Okay. So, the moment somebody walks in, that vibration will start taking over. Even if I am not sitting, that vibration will start taking over. In my earlier house, I had a place where I meditated and almost 10-15 years meditation. So many Atmadana classes and all. So many. I don't think any place in that square foot of area, Atmadana classes have happened anywhere in the world. That much of a class have happened. See, in ashrams, Atmadana doesn't happen, classes. So, happened. And that place acquires a vibration. People say, just the moment you step in that place, mind calms down. So what happens is that place becomes vibrant. That vibration will be picked up. And the stones, see there's nothing unconscious. Everything in the world is conscious. It appears like a stone, but it's conscious. So they start absorbing. And that's how in our India, you know, India, we have a lot of holy places, places where saints have meditated. The mountains, Ramana Maharshi, Tiruvannamalai, all the places where saints meditate, people meditate. So now here the force multiplier is happening. So many people come and meditate. Even if you meditate 10-15 minutes, the vibration will change. It's like a battery. So you can take some vibration from your house. Plug in. Any questions? What all I said?
No, when I sat in my house, if I think of you, I will get
more
deeper. Really,
correct. I felt it. Correct. It'll happen. It'll happen because you get connected to myself.
Connection.
Okay.
So many times I used to think of you and do my meditate. At that time, I will get more power.
No. It'll happen. The connection will happen.
Yeah.
The vibration. Because I... not Prabhu,
yeah.
I is everywhere. For you, address for I is Prabhu. Like IP address.
Proxy.
No, I will get vibration from here. I feel that from here.
Yeah. Okay. So now the vibration from there, okay, I have touched that this place and that gear.
No,
I have not done that. I have not given to all of you?
Yeah.
Other day I was not come. Okay. I saw.
Okay, otherwise you have got it actually, vibration.
Yeah.
So that's actually is a vibration. That's called upasana, that's called kundalini upasana. So what I have told to you, jnana. Jnana is for nirakara brahman. Kundalini upasana is for sakara brahman. Okay. The realization happens in sakara and nirakara. I have given in very detailed in that Kathopanishad class, I have told what is the difference between upasana and jnana. So, after death, people who do Sakara Upasana, they will attain Brahmaloka. That means they will attain higher level loka. Their birth and death is there.
Yeah.
And when they die through here or here.
Sakara.
Huh. Upasana. See, there are 101 nadis in our body. There are 76,000 nadis. Nadis means channels.
Yeah.
Okay. They open out through eyes, ears, sense organs, skin. Okay. Depending on what you like most in life, which is vasana? Tongue. The person will die with mouth open. Okay. Somebody is very interested in the world, he will die with eyes open.
Yeah.
Somebody is very interested in sex, it will go through here. So the prana goes through a channel which is already normally used. Understand? A river, you see, no, the river, when the river flows, that a pathway is created. Like that, whatever you continuously use, that channel will be opening. The channel will be created, carving will be happening in the body-mind complex. So when the person dies, he will use that channel which is normally available. A person who is very intensely sense gratification, so he will use that channel at the time of death. And he will attain that loka where that is predominant. Okay?
So for moment, prana goes from here, except for
enlightenment. No, no, no. For the people who may have given vibration, people who feel the vibration here, right? So you meditate on that as me, as Prabhu or Guru. So then what will happen? That channel will be free. So keep that channel open. So then at the time of death, it will go.
That
is for people who don't understand this.
Said when you go from all these years.
No.
But this one, they say very few, and therefore a lot of people break coconuts at the time.
It's actually wrong, actually. It's a wrong understanding.
It's a wrong, but that's...
It's a completely wrong understanding.
Yeah.
What happens is that monks, when they die, they break a coconut on their head to leave the prana.
From there.
It is not. That leaving the prana, you have to learn when you are alive. And that is the process by which I have touched your head and the sahasrara is opened. So that sahasrara is opened. As long as you remember me, that channel will open and a prana will start flowing that. Okay. So that practice is called practice for going to Brahmaloka. Brahmaloka is not liberation. Okay. Liberation is Jivan Mukti. While you are alive, you have to realize you are Brahman. It's going beyond. It's the nirakara, nirguna. The process of us. What I call as Shravana Manana Nididhyasa is process for liberation, Jivan Mukti, when you are alive. This is a backup. If you are not able to get Jivan Mukti, what is the backup is Brahmaloka. This is the boon Nachiketa asked, very smart guy. Okay?
Even we don't want Brahmaloka.
No, he is very smart, Nachiketa. He said, tell me how to go to Brahmaloka. Okay? Brahmaloka is not highest. First he understood that. Then he understood Nachiketa. This is Vidya, which I told you. So then, now you tell me how to go to liberation. His question is, let me try liberation. If I can't happen, Brahmaloka. Back up. Okay. So this is the place where you attain Brahmaloka. So keep the channel open. By devotion. You please see, wherever the devotion is there, the channel will start vibrating.
Yeah.
Right? And you see a bhajan, prayer, or you go to a movie which is...
Water also
oozes
from here.
And it is very important. The channel is opening up. Sushumna Nadi. That's called Kundalini.
Achha.
Okay? And you listen to bhajans, prayers. Okay? Wherever you have devotion coming up, that will open up. So, keep that channel open every day through prayers, bhajans. So, in case you don't get Jivan Mukti, you have a backup. Any questions?
All in the dream world.
What is dream world?
Dream world.
Which is dream
world? But we are keeping the channel open.
Yeah, there's Brahmaloka is dream world only. Brahmaloka is dream world. Okay, when you awakening means you're coming out of the dream world. So because of some prabdha karma, whatever that, you cannot finally cross the liberation. You may get Brahmaloka, which is also good enough. It's like a consolation prize.
So you are saying inside the dream, it's a better place.
Obviously, no? Highest place.
Loka is like going to Swarga, finishing the karmas again.
No, Swarga is intermediate. There are 7 lokas. Bhuloka, Bhuvaloka, Suvarloka, Mahaloka, Janaloka, Tapoloka, Satyaloka. Satyaloka is the highest. Okay, Satyaloka or Brahmaloka. So Brahmaloka, there's no return. Brahmaloka, you read, listen to Kathopanishad, no? Because I have done very detailed, I have told.
Okay. Brahmaloka, there is no return.
Brahmaloka, there is a birth and death.
Death
is there, finally.
Yeah.
So, but life is long and enjoyment. Okay? After death, you may come back to earth. Okay? But after a long time. Okay? But typically, Brahmaloka, they have done a sadhana for liberation. They could not get it. In Brahmaloka, they will go and then after that, complete and go out.
They will finish up their sadhana in Brahmaloka.
Exit. Yeah. But motivation for doing sadhana in Brahmaloka is very less.
Too much enjoyment.
I've said the ego requires a push and pull.
Yeah.
That is very optimum in the earthly plane. No, that's one thing. There are two planes. Earthly plane or Brahmaloka, it happens. Brahmaloka to motivation for liberation is very less. There is no employment there. There is no job there. No night work. No harassment. Why will ego go for liberation there? Whether it's possible, it is possible. But whether anybody will attempt it? Okay. Any other questions? So all are clear? So after this what? So today your class gets over. Okay. Right? So after this, in your group, that Ramakrishna group, you can exit. You can exit. And there is a separate group is there, which in the Telegram group, Atma Jyoti Seniors group. Okay, you can, by clicking the link, you can join that Atma Jyoti Seniors group after this thing. So in that Atma Jyoti Seniors group, all the Atma Jyoti activities of meditation and everything is posted. Whenever you want to attend, you can attend. Always you are welcome.
Before they exit, ask them to save that link.
Yeah, you save the link and, right? Mm. Okay, whatever is that? Okay, you...
Some of them don't have Telegram.
Oh, you don't have Telegram? How many people don't have Telegram? Okay. So, I think you download a Telegram app. You just...
Link.
I haven't downloaded
Telegram. Yeah, download Telegram
app. So, you click on that link and...
It'll
so, you have given that link?
Yeah, I have given that link.
He has posted today.
I have posted today.
Is it?
Okay. So once you join the Telegram group, if you want to continue, okay, it's not, this is not an organization. There's no organization here. It's all voluntary and nobody will ask.